Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
And very enlightening and eye-opening lecture by you. Okay, my question is, my name is Mrs. Mahin Yasir. My question is that, is there any indication in the Quran that children of Bani Israel are Muslims? Is there any ayah that indicates that?
Okay, the question is that you want a word Muslim and children of Israel in the Quran. You see, if you open Yunus Surah 10 and Ayah 90. Now, I will read in the Arabic, then I translate in the where she's asking that is there any place where the Muslim word has occurred with children of Israel. Surah Yunus 10 and Ayah 90, وَجَاوَزْنَا بِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْبَحْرَ فَأَتْبَعُمْ فِرْعَوْنُ وَجُنُودُهُ بَغْيًا وَعَدْوَى حَتَّى إِذَا أَدْرَكَهُ الْغَرْقُ قَالَتْ آمَنْتُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا الَّذِي آمَنَتْ بِهِ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلِ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Now, this is the narration. I will translate. And we took the children of Israel across the sea. So Pharaoh and his forces followed them in wrong and in enmity until he realized of drowning. He said, I believe that surely there is no God except him whom the children of Israel believe with him, and I am from those who are Muslim submitters. In this ayah, this is referring with Pharaoh and Musa salam. The Musa salam delivered the message to Pharaoh, and Pharaoh took the message, but he did not believe and practice. What happened? The Pharaoh and his forces followed them in wrong and in enmity. So Pharaoh followed Musa salam, but in wrong. That let's find out what Musa salam is trying to say, and to find fault and in enmity. Until he realized of drowning. You must understand, when we are trying to seek guidance from the Quran, a person should try to take guidance. If you suppose somebody comes here and trying to find fault in me, will not benefit. If suppose the people try to find faults in each other, you see, if somebody finds a false fault in me, I'm just giving an example, will not dust him in garden. You see, if you find a fault in me, that doesn't mean you will go to garden. So people try to learn the Quranic understanding as a knowledge just to find faults in others. That you are wrong, I am right, you are wrong, I am right. So Pharaoh and his people were following Musa Islam in enmity and in wrong until he realized of drowning. Finally found out that Musa Islam, God is right and we are wrong. So he said when he was drowning, I believe that surely there is no God, La ilaha, except him. Illalladhi amanat bihi banu Israel. I believe that surely there is no God except him whom the children of Israel believe with him. Wa ana min al muslimin, and I am from the Muslim submitters. So the children of Israel, he says that I believe surely that there is no God except him, and to whom the children of Israel believe. The children of Israel are believing the God, the same God, and he says, I am from the Muslims. He doesn't say, I am from the children of Israel. I am from the Muslims. I am the submitter. I am the Muslim. So children of Israel were Muslim submitters. So now at the end of his life, he wanted to enter to become a Muslim. But he didn't say, I want to become a children of Israel. I am one of the submitters. Believe, submitters. Well, I am submitting now. But it was too late. So this also proved that at the time of death, people say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, give him some honey, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. So he was dying, he said, La ilaha illallah amanat bihi banu Israel, wa ana minal muslimin. So at the time of drowning or the time of death, you recite one kalima, 1,000 kalima, doesn't benefit you, but that is the end of your life. You have to, in your lifetime, you have to amend and correct and believe and correct in your lifetime. The life you are leading, you lead your life as Pharaoh was leading. In arrogance, in wrong, and in falling in enmity with Musa Islam. And when he was drowning and he knew that this is my end of life, he says, I believe there is no God. I believe what of the God of children of Israel, and I am from the Muslim submitter. Allah did not accept it. So we should, what the lesson is, first of all, your answer, Muslim children of Israel are Muslims, right? Salaam
alaikum, Sheikh.
Jee,
my name is Nasreen Wali. From your lecture, we came to know that
present time Muslims are the scribes and not the Jews, present day Jews. Can you tell me any ayah from the Quran which says about the Jews, present time Jews?
Okay. You see, generally, the question is that if it's not heard properly, the present day we have come to know the people, the Muslim submitters are the children of Israel, and people are believing that the Jews are the children of Israel. You see, Quran used the word Hud, Hadu, Yahud in Arabic. Hud, Hadu, and Yahud. And in the translation of these three words are translated in Arabic, is that these three words have occurred in the Quran. Hud, Hadu, Yahudi. These three words have occurred in the Quran, and people have translated these three words as Jews in English. So now if you look in the Surah Maida 64, I will be reading one or two ayahs referring to Yahudi or Hud, referring to Jews. In Surah Maida 64, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةً غُلَّتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَلُعِنُوا بِمَا قَالُوا بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانِ يُنْفِقُ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ وَلَيَزِيدَنَّ كَثِيرًا مِّنْهُمْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا وَالْقَيْنَا بَيْنَهُمُ الْعَدَاوَةُ وَالْبَغْضَاءَ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ كُلَّمَا أَوْقَدُوا نَارًا لِلْحَرْبِ أَطْفَأَهَا اللَّهُ وَيَسْعَوْنَ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَسَادًا وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. And the Yahud or the Jews, the lenient, they say that the hand of Allah is cuffed, tied up. Their hands are cuffed, tied up, and they are cursed with what they have said. But both hands are outspread, but both his hands are outspread. He spends how he wills, and what is revealed to you from your Lord definitely increases the majority amongst them in tyranny, unjustly harsh, cruel, and rejection. And we have put enmity and hatred amongst them towards the day of resurrection. Whenever they ignite the fire of war, Allah extinguishes and make an effort in the earth to cause corruption. And Allah does not love those who are mufsideen or the corrupt. In this ayah, if you will note, the Jews' psychology is mentioned. This is nowhere in the Quran Allah says that I have blessed the Jews. In the whole Quran, Allah has blessed the Bani Israel, the children of Israel. In this he says, the Jews are saying that Allah's hands are tied up. So Allah said their hands are cuffed. Allah said their hands are cuffed up, and Allah has cursed them for what they say. So you see, you read the ayat, and you will find that nowhere in the whole Quran Allah says that the blessing is on the Jews, Hadu, Hud, or Yahudi, and his hands are outspread. And further, they like to kindle the fire of war. So Jews are always trying to kindle the fire of wars in the world. The wars you see in the world are the kindled by the Jews, according to the book Quran. It says, "Kullama awqadu nara lil harbi atfa Allah." Whenever they kindle the fire of war in the world, it is Allah who extinguishes. So Jews are those people who are trying to kindle the fire of war all time, and Allah is always extinguishing it. So in the world, this is the behavior of the Jews. And further, another ayat is Surah Al-Jumu'ah 62 and ayah 6 and 7. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ هَادُوا إِنْ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ لِلَّهِ مِنْ دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّوُا الْمَوْتَ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ وَلَا يَتَمَنَّوْنَهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ. Say, O Hadu, or those who are Jews, if you claim that you are awliya, protectors of Allah besides other people, then wish for death if you are truthful, and they will never wish for death for what their hands forward send ahead. Allah is nowhere with the oppressors. Now, another behavior of the Jews are, they think that they are the awliya ulillah, the Jews. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ هَادُوا إِنْ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَا ulillah. Say, O Hadu, those who become Jews, if you claim that you are awliya ulillah, protectors of Allah besides other people, then wish for death if you are speaking the truth. So you will see in the world people who are claiming that they are the awliya Allah, protectors of Allah, those who think they are the Hadu, the Jews. So Jews are explained by the Quran in that they themselves are claiming to be the protectors of Allah or the awliya of Allah, but Allah is saying nowhere in the Quran that they are the favored people. Now my explanation to you is the Quran describes about Hud, Hadu and Hud, many verses. I have delivered a separate topic of the what the Quran says about Hud, Hadu and Yahudi, a separate topic. But they are not favored people like Bani Israel. Bani Israel, children of Israel are separate people who are favored of all worlds, of all times.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum.
My name is Hassan Madrali and yes. I have a question for you, please. In the Quran, children of Israel have been blessed by the Almighty Allah. Is there any verse which says that all the prophets are blessed by the Almighty Allah?
Okay, thank you. Surah An-Nisa 469, you see there, the question is that Bani Israel are blessed. So definitely the prophets who Bani Israel, among the children of Israel came the prophets and the messengers. Among the children of Israel came the messenger and the prophets. When children of Israel are blessed, of course the prophets should be blessed. And you can see in Surah An-Nisa 469, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. And whosoever obey Allah and His Messenger, so they are with those whom Allah has blessed over them from the prophets and truthful ones and witnesses and those who correct, that is a beautiful companionship. Another verse is Surah Maryam 19 and Ayah 58. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ آدَمَ وَمِمَّنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْرَائِيلَ وَمِمَّنْ هَدَيْنَا وَاجْتَبَيْنَا إِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُ الرَّحْمَنِ خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا وَبُكِيًّا. These are among the prophets on whom Allah has blessed. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. So Allah said these are among the prophets whom Allah has blessed. From the offsprings, these prophets were from the offsprings of Adam and from those whom we carried with the Noah's Ark and from the offsprings of Ibrahim and Israel and from those whom we guided, we chose them. Whenever the ayahs, signs of the Most Gracious were recited over them, they fall down prostrating, weeping. These are the two references. There may be other references also on whom Allah has blessed the prophets. So the prophets are blessed among the children of Israel. The children of Israel themselves are blessed because of the book, Hukumah and Nabuwa. This is the reason that they are blessed, because they have got the book of Allah, they have got the governance of Allah, and they have got the Hukumah and Nabuwa and the prophethood. In the Quran, the children of Israel have got this Nabuwa and the Hukum, the governance and the book. You see, the prophets also have got the same thing. Yes, please.
इस सूरह अली इमरान का वर्स है कुलुत तान काना हिल्लली बनी इसराइल इल्ला मा हरम इसराइल अला नफ्सिही मिन कब्ल अन तुनज़्ज़िल तौरा कुल फ़अतू बित्तौरात फ़तलूहा इन कुंतुम सादिकीन. एंड यू आर वेरी वेल अवेयर ऑफ द ट्रांसलेशन. नाउ आई गो ऑन टू माय क्वेश्चन. It is very tangible from your spirit awakening lecture that the Muslims are the children of Israel, but the Muslims are fully aware of lawful and unlawful. So why the Israel made lawful and unlawful?
Okay. You see, I will translate for people who have not understood. Surah Al-Imran 3 and Ayah 93, I will explain what the question was. If the present day children of Israel are the Muslims, this question is because we have come to know that the present day children of Israel are the Muslims. So he's asking that the ayah in the Quran, Israel made lawful food unlawful, when we all know what is lawful and unlawful in the world. So the ayat that you are referring, Surah Al-Imran 393, Kullu ta'ami kana hillan li bani Israel. All food was lawful for the children of Israel. Illa ma harrama Israelu ala nafsi. Except what Israel made forbidden on his soul. Min qabli an tunazzala Tawrah. Before the revelation of the Tawrah. Qul fa'atu bit Tawrah. Come with the Tawrah. Fatluha. And recite it. in kuntum sadiqin, if you are speaking the truth. Now the question was that we Muslims know what is lawful and unlawful, and by that law, if Bani children of Israel also know what is lawful and unlawful, why Israel made unlawful? This is the question, and this is we have to understand. Now all the food that is mentioned in the Quran, which is lawful food, is mentioned. There's a different topic, what are the lawful food and unlawful food. The lawful food, in generally speaking, I'm just giving a general speaking, in Surah An'am, Al-An'am, the cattle, those animals, there's cattle, you understand, cattle, like cow, goat, sheep, goats, and even this camels, they are all cattle, they come in the category of An'am, Al-An'am, Surah An'am. So in that An'am is mentioned the cattles, and the pears are also mentioned the cattles. So they are the lawful food, they are the lawful animals, you can say they are the lawful animals that can be eaten all over the world. Now the ayah says that all food was lawful for the children of Israel. This same I'm talking about, this cattle was lawful for the children. People know, we are Muslims, we know children of Israel know this, it's lawful for the children of Israel. Except what Israel made unlawful on himself before the revelation of the Torah, the law. This Israel made unlawful. So we have to understand who are the Israel. Sorry? Who is Israel? Group of people? Huh? Yeah. So I in the Surah 17:3, Zuriyata man hamalna manu. Israel are those people who are the offspring who were carried with the Noah's Ark. So you understand what happened. I will refer to a verse you write down in Surah Mu'minun 23 and Ayah 27. فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِ أَنِسْ نَعِ الْفُلْكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا وَوَحْيِنَا فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا وَفَارَتَ النُّورِ فَاسْلُكْ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجَيْنِ اثْنَيْنِ وَأَهْلَكَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَبَقَ عَلَيْهِ الْقَوْلُ مِنْهُمْ وَلَا تُخَاطِبْنِي فِي الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا إِنَّهُمْ مُغْرَقُونَ. Then, now this I am reading the translation, then we'll discuss. Then we inspire to him, that is Nuh al-Islam, that you manufacture a ship within our eyes and our inspiration. Within our eyes and inspiration, you manufacture a ship. So when our order comes and the oven of the earth boils, then in it insert two from every pairs, and your family except from them to whom the saying is preceded over him, you do not address me in those who are oppressed. Surely they are those who will be drowned. Now let me clarify this verse. Now what is happening? Allah says to Nuh al-Islam, you construct a ship. And on the ship, within our eyes, that ship was governed, and Allah was making sure that the ship was constructed in front of him, in my language. So Nuh al-Islam was making the ship, and when it was made almost complete, so Allah asked Nuh al-Islam, or Nuh al-Islam asked Allah, vice versa, that the believers will board the ship. Okay? Believers, I have already discussed, the believers will board the ship. They are the Israel. This is how Israel will become. So they will board the ship. So when they were boarding the ship, so Allah said, insert two from every pairs, from every pairs take two. Now another thing, what kind of pairs of each pairs he will take two? He took lion, he took elephant. An'am, very good. So, but all the An'am can be possible. Suppose they were in Pakistan. I'm just giving an example, just to create an example. Suppose they were in Pakistan. The ship was here. Suppose. So, you can find goat here. You can find cow here. You can find what?
Camel.
You can find camel? No. In Karachi I'm talking about.
Sheep.
No, camel is not here. Sheep is here. Okay. Now, if these three, four animal pairs are taken, but they could not take the camel. So this food was for the Israel, Nuh al-Islam and his group, and they floated. And when they landed, or the ship was, Allah said, and Barakna, you come flow. So these were the food they were taking. So they thought there was a camel there in Jeddah. They landed in Jeddah and they found the camel. So he said, no, no, we can't eat this camel, because they were taking this only food from Karachi, they took only this food. So this is how Israel made unlawful the camel was also lawful for children of Israel or for the Muslim community, except the community on the board the ship, they made unlawful, Israel made unlawful, because they took each pairs of the camel, anam, the cattle, but they couldn't get those every animal at every city. You can't get, normally some animals are there, some animals are not there. So whatever they were not in the Bible says the whole, they took all animals. The Bible says that the whole world was drowned. This is what biblical, though don't bring that confusion in the Quran. It was a particular area, like the earthquake came or the tsunami came in Japan, not in the whole world, or in Kashmir, or in specific areas. So similarly, this Noah's Ark was built in a specific area, in a specific people. So Nuh alayhi salam and believers, not his son, not his wife. The believers, they were boarding on the ship and they took some food with them. Allah said, take, insert two from every pairs of your pairs and your family, except from them to whom the saying is preceded over them. So these pairs for food was taken. They were not the whole of Anams as mentioned in the Quran for the children of Israel, lawful. So they made it, the Israel, that group became Israel, and they made it unlawful when they, because they find camels or other animals also, and that was lawful because Quran says it was lawful. So let's say they made that, I read that ayah again. Kullu ta'ami kana hillal li bani Israel illa ma harrama Israel. Allah nafsis, except what Israel made unlawful over himself, min qabli an tunazzala Tawrat, before the revelation of the Torah, the law. So when, what is the Torah, the law? In the law, the Torah contains the law. Wa kayfa yuhakimunaka wa indama Tawrat, and how can they govern you? They have got in the nearest Torah, the law. In the Torah, fiha hukmullah. In the Torah is the hukum of Allah. So in the Torah is the governance of Allah. So the law contains the what is lawful and what is unlawful. The Torah, the law contains what is lawful and what is unlawful. So when you will hear the lecture on what is halal, lawful food and unlawful food, then you will come to know what is halal and what is unlawful. So here it says, قُلْ فَاتُوا بِالتَّوْرَةِ فَاتْلُوهَا. You bring the Torah, the law, and recite it. In kuntum sadiqin, if you are speaking the truth. So what I was referring to, how Israel made unlawful on himself before the revelation of the Torah. All food was lawful on children of Israel, all anam was lawful, except what he made unlawful. Those are those specific people who board on the ship with two pairs of every kind. This is the answer.
We have concluded that Israel are the Zurriyatan Man Hamalna Ma Nuh. They are the offspring of those who were with Nuh alayhi salam. The verse that you just read now, earlier on in answering the last questioner, was Illa Ma Harrama Ala Israel.
Ala Nafsi.
Ala Nafsi. Now, nafsi he
singular.
Is singular. So, this, why would it be singular if Israel are a number of people?
You can take Adam as a plural and as a singular, right, in the Quran. Okay. So, take one also, no problem.
Okay. Okay. And in Surah 19, which we read earlier on,
Zuriyat Ibrahim Israel.
Yes.
So,
over there also.
I will read this for you. 58. It says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ عَلَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ آدَمَ. Now, this is the from the prophets, Allah has blessed from the prophets. Then is from the children of Adam or the offsprings of Adam. Okay? وَمِمَّنْ حَمَلَّا مَعْنُوْ. to whom we carried, this is the Allah blessed, from whom Allah carried. Noah alayhi salam, whom Allah blessed them. Women Durat Ibrahim, and he also blessed from the offspring of Ibrahim and from the offspring of Israel. You see, from the offspring of Israel is also blessed, and whom he carried, they are also blessed. They are two separate, not same.
Okay, if we now in this verse, Mimman Hammalna Manu.
Yeah.
This category of people is Israel.
Yeah.
Israel.
Yeah.
And Zuriyat Israel is separate.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. But you know, it's just like that, look like this, looks like this. Yes. But you see, Wamin Duryati Ibrahim, why Israel? The Zuriyat is also applying on Israel. So, this is referring to Zuriyat Israel is also blessed, and whom Allah carried with the Noah's Ark is Israel, they are also blessed. Okay?
Thank you.
This concludes today's session. Thanks for your patience. Assalamu alaikum. ورحمة الله وبركاته